India's ancient buildings speak of a civilization that believed in a spiritual connect with nature. Its forts, palaces, and houses were built in harmony with nature, and very often with limited wastage of resources. Over the last century, as buildings reached higher into the sky, they became symbols of modernity and progress. But somewhere along the way, buildings also became detrimental for the Earth's climate. Today, 40% of energy-related global emissions are attributed to buildings. 60% of waste comes from buildings or related activities. But on a smarter planet, buildings can be designed differently. Buildings that harness nature. Buildings that need less energy. Buildings that breathe. This was the vision that created GRIHA, or Green Rating for Integrated Habitat Assessment. GRIHA is a tool that measures a building's environmental performance on a scale of 1 to 5, based on predefined benchmarks and criteria. Developed by TERI, GRIHA has been adopted by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy as India's national rating system.
TERI's been working on sustainable habitats and buildings for over two decades now. And as part of our work, we have necessarily had to go into several rating systems that are used for defining sustainable habitats around the world. And once we went into depth on these rating systems, we realized that our conditions are very different from those where these systems have evolved. And therefore, we decided to develop a rating system of our own, GRIHA. And in this effort, I must say, the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has played an extremely vital role in giving us the kind of encouragement, support, and technical inputs that made GRIHA what it is.
GRIHA brings together the best of India's traditional architecture and modern technology to build green buildings. It ensures that a building uses energy and water optimally and generates minimum waste through its life cycle. Along with all of this, it ensures the well-being of each person associated with the building, right from the construction laborers to occupants of the building. If you choose your building to be a perfect GRIHA, this is where it begins. Your site planning must conform to the master plan of the region. You must preserve agricultural land or protected land and trees on the site. The topsoil should be carefully separated, preserved, and reused for landscaping once the building is complete. During construction, you must regulate air pollution. For example, barricades can help stop the dust from spreading into the surrounding areas. Your building can use a variety of environment-friendly materials with high recycled content. During construction, you must ensure safety and sanitation standards for your workforce. Your building can have pervious or grass paving to allow rainwater to percolate. You may also build a provision for rainwater harvesting, thereby reducing the building's total water requirement. All external lights of your building can have automatic controls and can be powered by solar energy. You can plant as many native plant and tree species in place of water-guzzling lawns. You can have efficient plumbing systems and sensors to minimize wastage of water. In a hot climate, GRIHA buildings are designed to allow minimum heat to enter the building. Smart shading techniques and controlled glass areas stop direct solar radiation into occupied spaces, but they ensure good diffused light inside the rooms, thereby minimizing the use of electrical lights during the day. The building energy systems, such as lighting and air conditioning, are designed to achieve high energy efficiency. While most upcoming developments rely heavily on generator sets, GRIHA buildings meet 1% of their internal energy demand with on-site renewable energy. In all, GRIHA aims to reduce, reuse, recycle and reinvent. To monitor this, there's a mandatory post-occupancy energy audit.
In our experience, we have found GRIHA to be a win-win situation from all fronts, from the viewpoint of the developer, the designer and the end user. The reasons for that are predominantly three that we found. One, GRIHA rates buildings that are non-air-conditioned as well as air-conditioned, as well as hybrid buildings. So the GRIHA has the potential to cover buildings that are in the housing typology, in commercial, retail, a very wide gamut of buildings that covered and get dealt with in terms of local conditions as well as their global modernity. Two, GRIHA helps reduce the operating cost of a building by 30 to 40%. With negligible impact on the project cost. In fact, in some projects we have found that we've been able to decrease the initial capital cost of the building with a net 30 to 40% reduction in the operating cost of the building. Mm-hmm. And third, above all, is that it makes the process incredibly simple. From concept to the final rating, we find that GRIHA is a partner in hand-holding us through the entire process of enabling an integrated design approach to help reduce the cost of the building as well as its operating cost.
Government has taken a decision, Government of India, that all its new buildings will be GRIHA 3 or 4 star rated. The CPWD has taken a decision that it will only construct similarly rated buildings. And we are telling all organizations that you should please adopt GRIHA. And we are telling all the private sector people too.
See, GRIHA actually gives developers the ability to get certification which is certified by the Ministry of India. So, which gives consumers the confidence that, you know, this is not just something that a developer is saying. As most of the developers say, they say green and they talk about a lot of things, but it's difficult to deliver. And there is a monitoring body who's monitoring how actually the greenery which you are promising and which you are saying as GRIHA certified is actually monitored by the government. So, I think it gives much more credibility.
GRIHA is now administered by an independent body, Adarsh, jointly set up by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy and TERI. Adarsh brings together a range of stakeholders from policymakers to architects and engineers. It is also developing a robust pool of evaluators and trainers across the country with the objective of tapping local knowledge.
After all, you cannot have a rating system where you have one size fits all. Ultimately, sustainability has to be defined on the basis of local conditions. And that's precisely why we are in a major program to train evaluators and trainers all over the country.
Traditional architecture worked in synergy with nature. GRIHA ensures the revival of that old Indian wisdom. And is not merely a rating system, but a commitment to give a new direction to the building industry in India, to help every builder build wise and build green.